Demand for tropical hardwood, such as mahogany, used for high-end musical instruments, is high. The natural supply of these woods is decreasing. Many of the most valuable remaining specimens are found in remote areas where biodiversity is high and law enforcement is scarce. In this kind of environment, buyers face a challenge when it comes to purchasing wood that meets the legality requirements of today's marketplace. In the rainforests of Honduras, we encounter two examples where the companies involved choose to invest in long-term relationships and systems to manage the risk of buying illegal wood.
We were able to track from tree all the way through to receiving the lumber. So there's really very little chance of any kind of illegal processes going on. We put a lot of money in advance and a lot of faith and a lot of support, but we're where we want to be.
In these examples, intermediary actors play a vital role in connecting communities to buyers, managing risk, and raising the odds for legal trade. In and around the Rio Platano Biosphere Reserve, in the Mezquitia region of eastern Honduras, a number of communities have established forestry cooperatives for extraction and production of mahogany timber from their lands. In this region, illegal mahogany traffic has been recognized as a serious problem by the Honduran government and international organizations, including UNESCO. Cases of illegal logging and corruption have plagued the Biosphere Reserve's recent history and continue to undercut legal trade. Mahogany is protected internationally by CITES, the Convention on International Trade of Endangered Species, because of its increasing scarcity. Because it is a CITES species, trade in mahogany requires additional permits and licenses authorized by national authorities in both Honduras and the importing country. One local organization, Fundación Madera Verde, and its US-based affiliate, Greenwood, work directly with communities to build capacity and track mahogany extracted from their land. Using Helvetia barcoding and control intelligence technology, the wood is tracked from the community forests all the way to Taylor Guitars in California.
Bueno, nosotros como Fundación Madera Verde hemos estado facilitando el acompañamiento técnico, legal y administrativo a ciertas cooperativas agroforestales.
Helvetia was approached to support Madera Verde in putting in place a complete chain of custody system. The tree is identified, it is GPS referenced and located, the species is recorded, it begins the process of tracking all of the material that comes out of the tree through the supply chain.
But I think what we're seeing is a new paradigm and an organization now around the suppliers.
La cadena de custodia es una cosa muy buena para mejor para mejor legalidad.
La cadena de custodia es importante porque con este punto se mira desde donde cortaron el árbol, comienza ahí la cadena de custodia. Entonces eso lo van pasando por una computadora y va dando a conocer desde dónde salió aquel bloque y de dónde viene el árbol.
Another organization, the Rainforest Alliance, provides technical assistance to the local cooperative union, UNICAF, to build capacity and help members get their product onto the global market. UNICAF's goal is to sell wood from forests managed according to standards set by the Forest Stewardship Council, FSC. This wood is tracked through a chain of custody system and is utilized by companies like Gibson Guitars.
Bueno, uno es que ya tenemos bosques certificados, la planta que ya va a ser certificada, si hablamos de legalidad, eso no es si me sirva, ¿no? Luego una cadena de custodia que viene desde allá, que garantiza que este producto viene totalmente de allá, porque como viene ya sellado con su sello y entra al plantel.
In both of these supply chains, intermediary actors help communities comply with the laws in Honduras, including CITES requirements. They facilitate control along the supply chain to keep illegal wood out and document the legality to the end buyer. These practices, in turn, appear to discourage corruption and help demonstrate compliance with the U.S. Lacey Act. Donor support helps maintain these programs.
Pues para mí vale la para nosotros vale la pena porque año a año pues lo van reconociendo más, principal las autoridades nacionales y vamos para el extranjero reconocidos más y pues no hay mucha exigencia de las postas que porque tanto apenas miran la manera como va pues se ponen bien.
But we've been in business with Madera Verde and the co-ops in Honduras for 10 years. Now, the really cool part of it, in addition to the legality, we're helping a community as opposed to a company. So they rely on this as a source of income, which betters their community, gives them the ability to expand and, you know, make it a better place to live.
Intermediary actors like Fundación Madera Verde and Greenwood, UNICAF, and Rainforest Alliance play a significant role in facilitating a more transparent and systematic trade from Honduras to the United States. Systems like FSC certification or barcode tracking provide another layer of assurance in this remote and high-risk environment and help dedicated buyers like Taylor and Gibson meet the legality requirements in today's marketplace.